Hey guys, this is Eskimo Poodle, and we are here to start a new Let's Play series, Resonance of Fate, on the Sony PlayStation 3, also available for the Xbox 360. This is going to be a completely blind playthrough. I've been looking at playing it for a little while, but finally, a YouTuber by the name of Edgar Hector, I do believe it was, told me that it was a pretty good game and that I should try it out. And I think it was on sale somewhere. That's what I eventually picked it up off the Steam store, not the Steam store, the PlayStation Network store. So I picked it up. We're going to go ahead and play it. This is going to be, like I said, 100% completely blind playthrough. I only know a very few things about the game, and that's like the first like couple characters' names. One's like, I have no idea, actually. There was like a chick named Leanne. Yeah, Leanne, Zephyr, and then some other people. I know that a little bit about the damage types of the games. It's a Japanese RPG, from what I can tell, in a steampunk style. And it's gun-based gameplay, but I don't think it's like a first-person shooter gunplay. I think it's just like your primary weapons is just guns, and then it's incorporated into the battle system that way. So we'll be figuring that out. This series is going to be in 720p, because apparently the PlayStation 3 version doesn't support 1080, so we're just going to have to live with it, but it should be fine for the most part, I think. I don't think it'll be that big of a problem. Slightly lower file sizes. And these motherfuckers with that goddamn car out there. The main reason I got it on the PlayStation 3 compared to the Xbox 360, even though the Xbox 360 would let you get a slightly higher resolution, is that usually my Xbox is a little louder than my PlayStation for a little while. Plus, I played a couple games recently on the Xbox and not too many on the PlayStation, so I might as well do it this way. It's made by Tri-Ace, and typically Tri-Ace games have multiple difficulty levels. Like, for example, Lost Odyssey had normal, hard, and Infinity mode, and in order to unlock hard, you had to beat normal. In order to unlock infinity, you had to beat hard. I think it was only those three besides easy. And yeah, for this game, there's actually 10 difficulty levels from what I understand. And each one, you have to beat each previous difficulty level. So yeah, that'll be a real pain in the ass, but we'll just have to deal with it, I guess. So let's go ahead and get started right away. By the way, I don't think you can even choose your first difficulty level. I don't think it even gives you the option of difficulty levels until your new game, next one or whatever. But anyways.
I'm still alive.
Huh? What'd you say?
I'm really alive.
Not for long, you aren't.
I don't know how, but I'm alive.
How can you smile?
You're smiling.
Me? This is it.
Huh?
Don't look away.
But I... Don't look away? Which way?
Down.
You going out?
Get ready to head out. You too, Zephyr.
A story mission has been added to the mission memo list. Okay, sounds cool. Let's see, let's go ahead and try to figure out why that chick was trying to commit suicide in the cutscene there, and also try to figure out if she intended to be saved, or I don't know what she was doing, but yeah, I guess we're going to go look for work. Cafe Chelsea, huh? I don't know what's over there, but that's why we're going to go over there and find out. Rainy Bridge. Okay, we'll have to look for that. Yeah, except for the bridge is off limits. Fantastic. The guild, huh? Hey, wait a second. There's a guild into my other LP that I'm doing right now. Okay. I don't think we can go over here, yeah? Yeah, they're not going to let us out. Okay, so let's see if there's anything in the house here real fast before we get too far. From what I understand, most of the cutscenes and stuff are going to be voiced, so I'm going to not voice any of that. I'm not going to talk... for various in-town cutscenes. A lot of it, I don't think it's make that much of a difference. Every once in a while, I might, but for the most part, probably not. Chalkboard. Oh, this is saving our game. Okay, cool. Actually, something else, something about this game that I noticed when I was looking through the game manual that I really liked, if I can get to it, it'd be great, is here on page 6, you have the suspending game, so at the world map, we're in dungeon areas where there's no enemies. Select suspend game from the pause menu to create a temporary game save. There's only one slot for a suspended game, and this data will be deleted when the game is resumed or overridden if another game is suspended. So basically, if you're in the middle of a dungeon and suddenly you have to go, like, for an emergency or something, you can just go ahead and, get a quick temporary save. If there's no save point nearby, and you're good to go. So that's awesome. I like that. Let's go ahead and see what this flashy thing is. A bestiary. Huh. I don't think we find anything yet. Yeah, we haven't found anything. Okay. Okay. And what do we got over here? Ooh, rest on the sofa. Let's take a nap. Why not? I don't know how long we're going to nap for. Usually every time I try to take a nap, it ends up being like 2 hours, or sometimes I'll just sleep for like 4 hours, and I hate when I do that. Ooh, nighttime? Hey, cool. I didn't realize they had a day-night system going on here. Can I get back to the daytime, though? Because that'd be great. I wonder if there's just, like, two differences, like, day and night, or if it's, like, morning, evening, night, whatever. It looks like it might just be the two, but, okay. And apparently the rest area is open 8 a.m. to 6 p.m., and there are trucks here. So, yeah, fortunately this is going to be 720p, but I think we'll be able to live with it. I'm not going to be too terribly worried about it. Ooh, here's another couch. There's a wardrobe. That's kind of weird.
Now we're talking.
Secret stash, huh? Oh, sure, let's take the secret stash then, why not? Ooh, 1,000 rubies, nice. Rubies are the currency of the game. Let's see. Yeah, down in the corner of that circle R right there, that's the currency. Huh, that's pretty cool. And it said here on the pause menu, L1, R1, switch characters. So I think if we go... Yeah, you got plenty of boobs there, fella. Good for you. And then we got the girl. I liked her little, what is it? Her shirt that she had on in the cutscene, but I don't know where that went. What a pigsty. Okay, so I guess talking to different people will give you different, or talking to different things with different characters or people with different characters to give you different dialogue. And we have clothes we can change into. It looks like Zephyr, the main character guy, is the only one that has anything. So we got the red, and then we got the white. Let's see here. I think for now we're just going to stick with the basic red, even though the white does look pretty snazzy. But for now we're just going to stick with the red, and then later on we'll switch it up every once in a while just to be different here, I guess. Let's see. Let's go ahead and see what's over here. Hopefully something awesome. If not, well, I'll just have to live. Your sand is moving on its own. Ah, you're not going for the panty raid. Oh, well, you gave it your best shot there, buddy. Is there anything over here by the bed? No? I guess we can't take a nap here. Let's see what you have to say about your panty raid. Where did I put that outfit? Okay, I guess her outfit's not there. Okay, sucks for her, but oh well. I like how you can get different reactions here. That's pretty cool. Right around here. Whole lot of nothing. Dang, I was hoping you was going to find another 1,000 rupees. Or rubies. Rubies, rupees, rubles, whatever. I like that little animation for the area showing up there. That's pretty cool. Not that it really does a whole lot, but hey, it's there. I like it. Let's see, ooh, a power generator, is that what this is? Yeah, I don't think it's going to matter too much, but let's over here, maybe a different area. Ah, Zephyr's room, okay, gotcha. As far as I can tell, Zephyr is the main character. Zephyr is the blonde kid. Not that blonde kid, just blonde kid, there we go. Alright, so that's nice there. Let's see, let's go ahead and jump down. Okay, I guess that's just a shortcut back down if you don't want to walk the other screen. Okay, that's pretty cool, I guess. That dang bestiary keeps trying to flash me, but oh well, we'll just have to live. Let's check out the pause menu real fast here. Let's see, Vacheron, Zephyr, and Leanne. Everyone's level 3. And I think the, what is it? On the side there, that little weight symbol, that little like anvil symbol, I think that's like your carry weight. Let's see, attack power, gauge break, knockback, charge speed. I'm not sure why you need a charge speed for a gun, but charge acceleration, rapid fire, bullet focus, magazine size, weight. Okay, yeah, so basically we have a carry limit. Okay, that's pretty cool. And it looks like there, it looks like it's saying there's another screen down there. Either that or it's just telling me to get out of there. Let's see, you got a handgun, it looks like. And hand grenades. Okay, cool. Throw an weapon that deals explosive damage, equip it to a grenade box to use. Huh. I'm not really sure. Let's see, then we got weapon capable of dealing scratch damage. This model excels in rapid fire. Various forms of ammo fit in this hard case. First aid. Packs a punch to patch up most scratches. Heals 1,000 points of scratch damage. And weapon capable of dealing direct damage. Model excels in rapid fire. Okay, from what I understand, from what little bit I've read about the game, is direct damage. Let's say you have a HP bar of 100 HP or whatever. With direct damage, you shoot them for 5 damage, and they take 5 damage. With the scratch damage, they'll take 5 damage, but then it'll also recover. Actually, with scratch damage, I guess it does more like 3 damage. It does slightly less damage, and then it also recover. Actually, I forget which one does less. I remember reading a very small amount of this. One of these between scratch and direct. I think scratch does more, I forget. But either way, scratch damage basically recovers over time, and you have to use a direct damage to make that scratch damage permanent. So you gotta watch out for that. But I'm sure it'll be explained much better than I'm explaining here, because I've only got a very basic understanding. I didn't look up a whole lot for this game. I just looked up like character names for the tags and pretty much it, really. I mean, I found a few things about the direct and scratch damage and some other stuff, but not a whole lot. Let's see, customize. I don't think we can do a lot with this yet. Looks like we can add stuff. That's pretty cool. How come that one has like a space in front of the muzzle and that one does not? And neither does that one. Okay. Let's see, mission memo. Star from the heavens. Visit the Cafe Chelsea on level 4, collect the parcel from Sullivan, see that it's delivered to my home at Chandelier. He can only see us at nighttime. Okay, so we're going to have to visit him at nighttime. Okay, gotcha. So that's where the day night system comes in. Oh, and I like how it tells you right here. Okay, so Hunter points are the stars, rubies are the circle R, and you get items occasionally. Okay, and you got mission. Available, completed, and incomplete. Okay, that's actually nice. It does it pretty easily for you. Let's see what you got to say, bud. Straight down the hill. Okay, I guess you don't have anything to say differently. What about you?
Hi.
Yeah, it's okay.
Hi.
I guess not everybody's going to have something different to say. I was hoping they might, but oh well. I can't read that, whatever that is. Cardinals. Okay, so they're the rulers. Prelate? I don't think I've ever heard that word. Alright, well, you do your studying. I'll do my gunplay here. Actually, does he say anything after that? I don't know. Let's see.
Hello.
No, it doesn't look like it. Okay. Hey, old-fashioned telephone booth that I can't make a click call to anybody with. And I notice that everything here seems to be gear-oriented or designed. I guess this is supposed to be like a steampunk-type atmosphere, and it's certainly showing, that's for sure. You've got a date? Cool. With who? Are you going to tell me with who your date is? I don't think she mentions. So basically she's laughing in our face that we have to go to work and she gets to go on her little date. Eh, good for her, I guess. Whoa, hello. You look kind of pale there, lady. Nope, nothing from you.
How are you?
Okay, looks like it's not going to be as much talking to people as I was thinking there might be. Maybe it's just search different areas and you'll get different items. Yeah, that's where I was trying to go, but you said it was, or somebody in my mission said it was blocked off or something. Energy supply, huh? Okay. The bulletin board. Okay, let's go check it out then.
Hi.
Okay, so looks like it kind of looks like it's kind of like a Final Fantasy Tactics Advance or Tactics games where you accept missions and then go on them from there. But I think it also has, like dungeons and stuff, for as far as I can tell. Okay, they're not going to let me go anywhere, I don't think. Nope. I like how the sign above the guild there says, "Shall we hunt?" I like it. It's very nice.
Hey there.
I don't have any energy hexes. I'm not even sure what an energy hex is at the moment. I'm sorry. Okay, so that's the bulletin board where it says wanted. Okay, gotcha, gotcha.
Hello.
Oh, you can explain stuff. Okay, cool. I'll go ahead and go into these, and then you can read them, I guess. So pretty much we do whatever they want us to. Okay, as long as I get paid for it, I don't really care. Okay, so everything's shared. That's nice. Oh, and they're gonna have a nice constant supply. That's nice, I like that. Oh, dang, I was already there. Alright, about missions, there we go, that's what I was trying to go to. So the guild gives green icons. And we gotta go find someone to actually go do the job. Okay, gotcha. And then red icons are, okay, so basically assassination missions. Gotcha. Oh, so for there, we don't gotta go find the client. Gotcha. So if you end a chapter when you don't have a finished, a mission unfinished, failed. Okay, so can we have a chance to... Okay, so we can choose to advance the chapters whenever we want to instead of it just automatically going forward. Okay, that's nice. I like that. Oh, cool. So it'll automatically put all the mission information in our little mission info on the screen there. That's nice. Okay, mission progress posted. Active. Okay, so if you just see a hunting mission, we can just go for it automatically without having to hunt someone down. And then we finish and go back to the client to get our reward. Okay, gotcha. Okay, cool. So we go someone that has a mission for us, and they'll be all MMO type and have a exclamation point. Okay, cool. That works. Hexes on the world map. I don't think I care for my world map to be hexed, but I guess we'll just have to deal with it. Oh, combat. Okay, gotcha. Items, rubies, and hunter points. Okay, sounds like a plan to me. Star icon represent your contributions to the guild. Every 100 points you get gets you a special prize. Okay. Oh, 9 prizes. Okay. So this is not very many levels, but you still get a reward for each of them. Oh, and they arrive by mail. Okay. Cool. Alright, that sounds like fun then. Let's go ahead and... What are you? Oh, the bestiary again. Okay. What about you there, sir? Machine guns can inflict scratch damage, but they can't knock out the target. Oh, so scratch damage doesn't let you actually kill anything, but it will let you do damage. And then direct damage... Okay, so scratch damage does more damage, but it can't kill, and you gotta use the direct damage to make it permanent, whereas direct damage does... Well, direct damage, but it's not very powerful. Okay, that's not too shabby, so... Pile on scratch, and then finish with the direct. Let me see if you say anything to different people. No? Alright, let's go see what's on the bulletin board here. New missions, perfect. Alright, so like they said, green is the one we gotta talk to people, and then red is the hunters. Okay, let's see. And we get items for each one of these. Let's see, very small amounts of hunter points, a couple rubies. Ooh, the bridge restoration gives us a pretty decent amount of rubies. And they give items too. Let's see, escape hex. Oh, basically it warps you back to the world map. Okay, that's cool. I like that. Anti-damage field that cuts the physical damage in half. Ooh, so that's like a nice protect spell or something like that. Okay, cool. And a dot sight for expansions. Okay, let's go ahead and take all of these. Rainy Bridge needs repairs. Patch broken grids and energy hexes so that Rainy Bridge becomes usable again. The good looking dude standing in front of the guild. Okay, yeah. And I like how it shows a picture of the client next to the mission here. That's nice. But they said that the red ones are the hunter ones. So that means we don't actually got to find this guy, right? Okay, I'm looking at this dot side, and I'm thinking this half circle is like accuracy or something. I'm not sure. They'll have to check it out. Let's see. Lex's knives. Left something at home. Okay, she's right in front of the guild. This guy was in front of the guild. And this guy is... pack of stray curves roaming around the other side of the rainy bridge. We actually gotta fix the bridge first, I do believe. But if we go into our mission, I think now it's... our menu, it goes... okay, there we go. Everything's here now. Perfect. I like it. I like how the story mission gives a whole bunch of rubies and hunter points compared to everything else. Okay, let's go ahead and... let me see something real fast. I wanted to make sure what that half-circle thing was. Charge speed. Speed at which the weapon charges. Again, I'm not sure how a gun needs to charge, but okay. I was hoping you might say something different now that I finished reading that, but oh well.
Hi.
Yeah, I checked it out. There's some good stuff for us to do, and you need something done, right? Okay, so you get the mission, you talk to the guy, and let's go from here. So we need to repair it. We need you to patch broken grids with energy axes so that Rainy Bridge becomes usable again. Oh yeah, I'm not sure what this energy hex is, so let's, see, the world map is composed of hexes. Some hexes have shut down due to degradation. Basil's operation to access them, you'll need to use an item called an energy hex to restore normal function. The area name of the next destination is displayed in a pink frame. Okay, so that's cool. So basically where you need to go is pink, that's nice. Areas that bear a mark to the left of the name are a safe place. Oh, okay, so that little white thing means it's a, safe. Okay. And if it's just pure gray, you can't do anything with it. Okay, gotcha. Time passes. We're in the world map. Current time is shown on the world map at the upper right. It can be viewed from the pause screen elsewhere. So, people act differently and enemies act differently during day and night. Okay, that's cool. I like that. And multiple tiers are connected by a network of elevators. Okay, we'll be able to get further and further through the basal area, which I guess is more or less the world map area. Enter Energy Hex Placement Mode. Select the Energy Hex to use. Place Hex. Place Energy Hexes can only be placed where they overlap or abut accessible hexes. Okay, I see that the first one is good. Maybe it's just because it's connected to the orange one. But I guess since it's on the second one, it's not connected to anything. You can't just like put them down for future use, I guess. Okay. Manual from the pause screen. We'll check that out later. Get energy hexes off of enemies you beat. Okay, so we gotta kill enemies to do this anyways. Alright, so we'll go check that out. Perfect aids. That sounds like it should be decent, I guess. Ask down at the arena. I'm not sure where the arena is, but... yeah, you can walk me over there. That's fine. That way I know where it is. That'd be great. Okay, so head to the arena for a refresher course. I might do that, just because it'd be nice.
How are you?
And what can I help you with? You're the one that needs the quest done for the Sun Left Something Behind, right? Core Lift 1. We need to give him some knives. Lex's knife set. Okay, sounds good. So not everybody uses guns, just, well, us. Core Lift 1 now. Please get those knives to him. Okay, so we'll get to that in a minute, but let's go ahead and... see, I think we explored pretty much everything off to near our house. Let's go explore what's down here. Something useful, huh? Bottle cap? Can I get the bottle cap then? How come I can't search this junk for a bottle cap? I don't want to go to the world map just yet. I want to see what else is here on the area here. Let's see. Oh, I guess it doesn't have like specific times. It just says daytime, morning, or I guess night, I guess. Or whatever the other one is. Ooh, something shiny. Custom kit set. Let's see what that is. Oh, perfect aid. Completely restores the target's HP. That's nice. Sounds awesome. And then they said custom kit set combined with other items of the Tinkerer to create custom gun parts. Bundle of fine knives belonging to the client's son is immaculately maintained. Okay, we'll have to find out where this guy is and get it to him at some point here. Razzle Street. How you doing, kid? Don't lecture me on how to say hi to someone.
Hey, listen.
You listen, you little twit.
Hey, listen.
Okay, I'm gonna leave you alone before I get irritated. Oh, there's a shop in here. Okay. Modifying guns. Try the rookie series customizing parts of the shop in the middle. If that doesn't tickle your fancy, you can have better parts made by the Tinkerer on the right. Okay, so we can dismantle, assemble, and just buy. So it's pretty much all or nothing type of shop here. I don't think I'm going to buy anything right away, but let's just see what they got. Let's see, you are... Oh, you're the dismantler. Okay, so let's see. We can dismantle our hand grenades and our rounds. And that's pretty much it. I don't think I'm going to dismantle those because I might need them. Yes, sir, I'm a hunter. Oh, you're the guy with the stray curves. Gotcha. I gotta get through the stray curves for, or the rainy bridge first there, fella.
Any ammunition you could imagine.
Let's see, we got first aids for scratch damage, status ailments, escape hexes we can buy, clairvoyance. Ooh, that's like a scan spell, it seems like. Let's go ahead and grab, let's grab two of them for right now. I don't think we need too many. It might be like some other games where you scan them and then it's permanent. See, rookie sight. Improves charge speed. It's heavy, though. Okay, so 6 pounds or whatever. Charge acceleration. It's heavy again. I'm sure we'll figure out more about the charge stuff later. Let's see. Okay, so one's for a handgun, one's for a machine gun. I was trying to figure out what the difference was, but I guess it's just what you can put it on. Rapid fire rate. Seems like every weight is considerable here. Automatically attacks if the action gauge reaches zero while charging, as long as there's at least one complete charge. Combined with other items of the Tinkerer to create custom gun parts. Powder gel. I think I'll worry about getting some of this stuff later.
Have a nice day.
Oh, go away.
Have a nice day.
And then you are the other guy, right? Okay, so we can just make various add-on parts. Okay. But we're not going to have to worry about that for a little while, I don't think.
What's up?
Oh, you're right. We're here to talk to you. Okay. I thought you were somebody different. What about you? Have I talked to you yet, dude? Training at the arena. Yeah, I'll probably go there just to see what the basics of combat are about, because that's what it seems like it would do. And what about you, buddy? Like, what kind of treasure? Oh, rubies. Okay, so that's the currency, I do believe. See, over here we got this looks like a clothing store.
How are you?
Oh, so we can change our outfit pretty much. I don't think it has a purpose, but if it does, that'd be kind of cool, I guess. So what can I buy? Okay, we can't buy anything yet. Oh well. We'll have to buy stuff later, I guess. Kind of sad that I can't go up this little ladder right here, but oh well. Alright, over here is... Hey, how about you tell me where I can get some cash? I don't care if you have money. I want money for myself, buddy. Okay, that's the world map again. Okay, so I don't think there's anything else for us to do at the moment besides go to like that arena place that they're talking about. So let's go ahead and go back to our house real fast. And then we can use the chalkboard to save up. And after that, we'll just call it an episode. The sun has set, but the stars are still in hiding. Well, you'll get famous one day, lady. Don't you worry about it. Or maybe not. I don't know, but we'll see. Hello, Gramps. Oh, you're still the dog guy. Okay. And I think over... Not bad at all. What did you get? You're going to give it to me if I have a different character? I guess not. I wonder if I could get those bottle caps that he was talking about earlier over here. Hey, glass shards. Cool. Okay. Let me see something. It seems like going into buildings gets rid of, or not gets rid of, changes the time. So if that makes him move, maybe I can get something else from when he was over here. Or better yet, we could rest up at the house and see if that gets him to move and see if we can't find something else over there. So I'm going to keep an eye out for that guy, see if he has anything found that we can take. Oh, you got a good date. Good for you. Charge time before an attack changes depending on how your distance is from the target. If we're closer, it charges up faster. Okay. Maybe it just takes longer to squeeze the trigger if you're further away? I don't know. Well, Chandelier is a pretty cool name for a city in the sky. I'll give her that. Oh, okay. Let's see. The next destination. Across Rainy Bridge, which we have to fix. Okay, we'll head there. See the full view map. Select on the world map for full view of Basel. Reactivating every hex on a level. I'm not sure what's going on there, but okay. Oh, maybe you get like a reward for it or something. He's not going to tell us. Okay, so if we press select, I guess it doesn't work here in the area that we're in. See, I want to rest up real fast, and then I'm going to go see what that old man was digging for. Then see if he has anything else. And next episode, we'll go ahead and try out the arena and all that other good stuff. I hope this old fart has moved on by now. If not, well, we'll just have to wait for him to go somewhere else. See, he was over on this screen right here. Yeah, he was digging around over here, right? Well, I guess he took it. Another bottle cap, huh? Right, let me try something here real fast. Maybe if you keep on like going around, you'll be able to get more glass shards or whatever. Or maybe because we waited for the resting option, maybe that won't let us get the next item that he has or whatever. Yeah, like I'm telling you, buddy, if you know any good ways to get rich quick, you let me know. The mines are our turf now. Okay, well, good for you. What are you doing there? I'll find out eventually, I guess. I'm assuming that this still isn't available because we haven't done any missions or whatever. That's probably what's going to advance the availability of shop stuff. Okay. I wonder if they'll say the guys look good, too.
How are you?
Okay, yeah, so she seems like everybody. Let's see, let's go over here. What have we here? Ooh, scrap iron. Okay, cool. I'll take it. And what are you doing, sir? So you're thinking about going to the arena, too. Don't worry, I'm thinking about going there, too, but... Well, I'm going to get there eventually here.
What now?
I still don't think the scrap iron and the glass is enough to buy anything or make anything or whatever.
I'm your man.
Oh, you make compact scopes. Let's see, one goes in the front, one goes in the back. Let's try... I don't think it matters. Let's go with the Alpha. Oh, it costs 3,000... It costs 3,000 rubies to make, though. Never mind, I think I'll hold off on that for a little while. Ooh, sub-barrel. Hang on. This does... rapid-fire rate and bullet focus. Looks like we can make one of each of these. Let's do that. So let's do that, and let's do that, and see what we get out of it.
You know where to find me.
Now let's see if we can't customize it real fast. Let's see. Let's try it on you. Let's see. That gives the reload speed or recharge speed or whatever. Okay, so there we go. We can do that. But you don't have anything to actually do it on. Okay, so let's try you then. So we can't actually put these things on. I made them, but I can't do anything with them. Why can't I attach these things? It looks like it should be able to go. Maybe we gotta line up like the little ends onto the things here. So, let's see, that's it. X. So, I think what it is we have to like... One has a circle X, one has an X. We have to figure out which one will actually attach to each one. Let's see, handguard, you have square. Okay, so there you go. Gotcha. So basically, whichever... You have to line up the icon on the attached part to the icon on the gun. Okay, gotcha, gotcha. All right, so let's see. You have an X. You can't do anything there. So the X one is not... usable on anything because we don't have any X's to put anything on. Okay, but still, now that I got that figured out, that's nice. I like it, I like it. Let's go see if a buddy boy over there has moved on so I can collect more glass or whatever he's capturing or getting or whatever. Let's see, are you still there, fella? Or did you move? By the way, I can't seem to move the camera angle like at all, so... I'm trying, but the right analog stick does nothing. Okay, I kind of want you to move out of the way so I can, you know, get that item that you're working on there, fella. I'm not gonna try forever here, but I will give it another minute or two of running around screens. I think last time when I advanced by using the rest shop or whatever, or stop or whatever, I think that made it so that I couldn't get what he was trying to have over there. Which is fine. I can deal with that. And it seems like time does pass here, even though it says it's passed on the mini-map or whatever. Let's see, we're still at the sunny phase. So I wanted to get to the next one. I'm just going to try going in and out of the guild a few times to see if that... does it? It might not. We'll see. If not, well, we'll just call it a day and we'll figure it out later. And I don't think they're going to add any new missions right after we got the ones we already have. Yeah, okay, so we're still good. Okay, now it's a half day time or whatever. Okay, so there is nothing else here. I was hoping he'd put something there, but I guess not. Maybe we had already found the one over here. Okay, so we're gonna call it a day here. Next episode, we're gonna go ahead and go out into the world map and maybe try out the arena and some other stuff. So guys, thank you for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Have a good night.